there's a kind of violence in the ways in which people are being, you know, bullied into settling for easy answers to really complex, difficult questions. Indeed, it's vital now that we promote openness, curiosity, a sense that questions remain questions or questions open onto other questions.
One of the reasons I like teaching is I learn from it. And if you ask students questions, their answers are really insightful.
One of the biggest problems was they didn't account for heat at all in their model.
They're bringing to the classroom a range of experiences. And what they often share and articulate is very thoughtful and offers a different way of thinking.
My father was a political prisoner and had received political asylum here in the United States. I wanted to teach because it was somehow a way of giving back to a society that had given my parents, basically, you know, a chance.
I had a great teacher of ancient history, and I developed a passion really from that moment.
Historians call it the third century.
For me, the goal of teaching history is to take students through the process of making an argument based on evidence and generating their own interpretations.
I vividly remember reading Oliver Twist by Charles Dickens when I was about 9 years old. It was an unexpurgated edition of the novel. It wasn't cleaned up for the young reader. So I remember being completely freaked out by the scene in which Sykes, who's this thuggish criminal, beats out the brains of the prostitute Nancy. And this made a really powerful impression.
Hey, folks.
You know, when I first started teaching, my thought process was that I needed a job. For real, that was my thought process. And then once I started teaching, it just sort of kept feeding me, you know? And I really appreciated what I felt like I was getting out of it, the relationships I was building, the amount I learned. I learned far more teaching than I ever learned in graduate school. Sorry to my teachers.
Through this period, people have developed models.
What we're trying to do when we teach is help people understand where ideas come from, what we don't know, and to become critical thinkers.
A big thing that I feel like I spend a lot of time in my classes focused on is trying to get students to understand how they're related to the problems that they see out in the world and are hoping to fix.
Engineering is playing for keeps. If you make a mistake in something that people's lives depend upon, it could have real ramifications. And that's something that, you know, is important to tell students. This, we're not messing around here.
I try to create an environment in the classroom that's open and welcoming to the students. And I think they really pick up on this idea that it's okay to try out new ideas, new arguments. It's okay to be wrong.
Having the opportunity to really push on a student hard in a way that they're uncomfortable and then be with them through it all the way. That's when they're like, oh, you know what, I can take risks here. This person's gonna have my back even after I screw up.
Noun versus to mark something, like there's some sort of...
I'm always grateful to the students who have the courage to say that they're stumped or to ask the very basic question about what may be the categories everybody else was thinking was obvious and perhaps not obvious at all, or their very obviousness is blinding us to something interesting and problematic that's going on.
And certainly when we reach the edge of my understanding, I'm more than happy to acknowledge that and point out where I'm speculating, where we're hypothesizing.
When you're given a question that you don't know the answer to, this can really facilitate a kind of collaborative learning that benefits the whole class.
Happen 3 or 2 later as opposed to...
They can see me modeling for them the process of working out plausible answers, persuasive answers, and I think that encourages them to try the same thing.
Debate, especially in sciences, is really important, and I think it's engaging.
Neither of them know what they're talking about, right? Because we don't know.
Everyone gets excited if you see a fight coming.
Mystical doctrine.
For me, what's crucial, what I want to happen in the classroom, is to get students excited and to have them come away hungry.
So it seems as if it's more easy recognizing the absence of...
The students at Berkeley are just so intensely curious, much more so than in other places I've taught.
Look how many of them are first-gen college students. You're first in your family to go to college and you're at Berkeley? Talk about killing it.
Of course, engineers always get a bad rap that they're somewhat myopic, tunnel vision type people, and that's simply not the case for a modern Berkeley student. I think they're very well-rounded, socially conscious. They want what they learn in class to be applicable to the betterment of society, and that is something very unique
Berkeley students are really ambitious and they're extremely talented. They go on to be world leaders in politics and business and academia. And because they're so talented, we learn a tremendous amount from them.
Rooted in the written word and like a decree.
Yeah, brilliant. When a class goes well, I really feel that I'm cheating them. We come from a class and I feel that I'm the one who's actually done the learning, maybe more perhaps than they have.
Every time someone comes from a completely orthogonal direction that I'd never even thought about, perhaps because they come from a culture that I've never had an encounter with, it helps me as a human being learn more and more and more.
In this context, I work with my students through some of this messiness that's happening in our country right now, first and foremost by connecting with them.
Can't help it.
In light of what's going on in sort of national and world politics, suddenly what perhaps we all took for granted in an earlier age, we can no longer take for granted.
There are things that we know and things we understand. And so I suppose at one level in the sciences, we are trying to teach or understand what that truth is, what the reality is. That may come with an uncertainty, but putting a lot of volume behind some alternative version of that reality doesn't make it true.
Probably at no time is that more important than now, when evidence and truth and facts have come up for debate in a way that goes beyond a kind of healthy respect for the ambiguities of evidence.
So in our introductory course, we talk about climate change. There are lots of news stories about climate, and there's a fair number of news stories that we would now call fake news. And so it becomes a teaching moment. If someone brings up a news story, we can figure out where the data comes from. Is it reliable? Is it not?
There's a lot of conversation about how people aren't talking to each other. At least here, they're like, oh, we don't know what the other side thinks. There's this binary. I think one of the most important things to do right now as a teacher is to smash those binaries.
It's a thinking together of the questions and issues that we're facing. And in that sense, it is a collaborative work.
I think the two keys to the success of
one of the most important things that I think history can do is to give our students a sense of context, a sense of where they are in time and space, and how we might remake the world in a better way.
Those of us who are earth scientists do what we do because we know that what we're studying affects how we understand the earth, and hopefully that translates into something bigger and better for humanity.
What's important today is the ability to teach students how to have an impact on society that is lasting and meaningful. I can't think of a place that does that in a better way than Berkeley.